Oh, let's take a look. Gated. Interim recovery. Aha, that's okay, that's for the logical problem. Okay, here's the drive. Okay, the drive has failed. Okay, this one shows it. Okay, now then, let's have a look at the operating system and see what it says. Yeah, this is the server running Windows Server Data Center Edition, and as you see on the operating system level, with the default installation of the operating system, you see nothing. Not even if you go here. And you can click click around and let's see, like disks. And because the thing is, it doesn't understand the physical disks on the RAID controller, so you basically just don't get it really wrong. You just get the logical volume, and then the storage pools is like on the higher level. So you're basically if you're running just with the out of the box Microsoft tools, then you don't get alerted to a RAID controller disk failure. Now, however, in all fairness, you can install additional software from HP where you can actually get the notifications into the operating system. Well, I think this is actually interesting. So if I wouldn't install any extra tools, then I'd have to rely on ILO, or I'd have to go and actually look at the server. Anyway, so let's have a look at the drive itself on the server. So anyway, here's the disk, it's that one. A little bit about these color encodings, that if it's blinking orange and green, then it's the actual hard drive is reporting that it's going to fail within its own. It's just run diagnostics on itself, and it's still integrated, it's still operating as a hard drive, but it's actually feeling very sick, and it says, I'm going to fail. So if it's blinking green, orange, then don't remove it, because it's still integrated into the RAID array, and you will run the risk of corrupting your data if you remove it at that point as well. But now, since it's actually failed, which means that it's just orange all the time, then you can actually remove it. And then these that have lit up, because these are critical to the operation, the parity operation of the RAID configuration. So it's warning you, you can't remove that, and you cannot hot remove that one or that one. But you could do, if this one failed, you could replace that one. The seller was nice enough to give me a replacement hard drive, pretty much. Questions not asked. And now we're going to take this out. And basically, it would be, yeah, I mean, if you can, it's good to shut down the server, power it down, and then change the drive. But actually, I'm going to do a hot swap, since I've actually taken a backup of the data that's on the drive. It would be fun to see what happens when we do. So let's pull this out. System still continues working. Yeah, check the operating system, access the C drive, still all operational. So now, anyway, now I have to go ahead and change this up. Put a new old one, and put it back in, and we'll see what happens. So, cut down the blocks, or Okay. Let's have a look. Scroll down. Look. Okay, so that's the controller, the logical drive, and then the physical drive since the second one. Degraded, not authenticated. No, it's not saying it's not working. Okay, let's split some time and see what happens.
You're absolutely not going to believe how I fixed that. So, I did some research on the internet, and it turns out that when you have the caddy, the two back screws, if you tighten them too tight, the contacts don't connect correctly when you push the driver. Yeah, I have to take this. I have to take the hard drive in out of the caddy. I have to loosen the two back screws and insert it in. Now it's going on. It's active, like I would have expected. And the ILO is indicating that it's what's the status now?
One last snapshot from ILO. Or if we look here now, it says that's the controller on the system board, so it's just yellow. And then you go logical drive, yellow, but it's no extra status. And then it says status is degraded, but it says rebuilding, and then all the drives are green. And the status LEDs are indicated of the same status. So anyway, just let it run on, in my case, overnight, and then it'll probably be done and finished by the morning. So anyway, I hope you found that informative. Please consider subscribing. Hit the like button if you thought the video was worth it. Merch is available. Or if you just want to buy me a cup of coffee, the links are in the description. And I'll see you in the next one.
Okay, they are, as far as I've researched, they're also 1 gig, so it's not a 10 gig connection. In my case, it doesn't matter. And the interesting thing is that this is small text that says Alcatel Lucent switches. So that's two of them. Yeah, pretty the biggest switch manufacturer. No, I picked them off a seller site for like absolutely, in my opinion, a steal. These are 5 kilos each, they got 3 fans, nice cross. These are 48 ports for module places. They are managed, if I'm wanting to manage them on board. They're stackable. I was actually thinking of buying more useful. Yeah, and as I said, I don't know, find it kind of amazing because I paid like $30 each. It's like a steal. Okay, I do know why people don't, probably why they're selling it so cheap, is that it's throughout 1 week, but from my use, that's fine.